So what is the difference between those ingredients that give you a matte finish and those ingredients that give you the glossy finish? I did massive research about their company, about their values, about satisfaction of their employees who work there. This video is not sponsored at all. It's just my, you know, geeky discovering and willing to share with you what is good on the market and what is not. How the companies that we buy from treat environment. Are you ready? Hi, welcome on Cosmetology Channel. My name is Kate and I'm a cosmetologist. And I want to raise awareness around us, normal consumers, about what products do we buy. How the companies that we buy from treat environment, animals, and what actually do they put in their ingredients, in their boxes. So today is actually a review and we will be reviewing Kiko Milano. This is the first episode of this series about sustainability, environment and cosmetic brands. So if you want to stay with me on this journey, make sure that you subscribe and you have the notification bell on. Let's jump to the review. Today we'll be discussing two different types of products that we all use and we very often forget to look into what those products have. And those are lip glosses and mascaras. And I chose Kiko actually by accident. I was in London some time ago and I went to their shop and I was positively surprised. And yeah, I was actually astonished by their service, by their politeness and actually being super specialists in the brand, in the beauty area. I had the pleasure to meet wonderful people there and they didn't know that I'm a YouTuber. They didn't know I'm like super unknown YouTuber right now. So they didn't know anything about me and they didn't even have any idea that I will actually review their brand. So I will do that right now. What I did, I made myself a lucky owner of three lip glosses and one mascara and one primer. And I chose them precisely for this video to review the ingredients of that company. So, are you ready? We'll look into two different types of lip glosses. One is the glossy one that has, you know, a lot of sparkle, shine and gloss finish. And then we'll also look into the matte lipstick, lip gloss. And we will also look into mascaras. And I chosen to review mascara that comes with a primer because this is a full set. So I want to review full package here. So what is the difference between those ingredients that give you matte finish and those ingredients that give you the glossy finish? And we will first jump to a lip gloss that is from this series. It's a Hydra Lip Gloss, a 3D. This series of lip glosses actually is not water-based. So what is the base of those lipsticks? Are you curious? So first ingredients that we will see is polybutin, and this is actually an oily liquid that is non-toxic, non-cancerogenic in its main builder of those glossy lipsticks all around the world, all around the brand. And second ingredient in this lipstick is octylodecanol. And this is very similar alcohol to sterile alcohol. Basically, it's transparent liquid that supports consistency of the product. It secures that it's emulsion and all the ingredients are well blended. So again, no toxic, non-cancerogenic, we cannot say anything wrong about that. This ingredient is titanium dioxide, and this is coloring agent here. Titanium dioxide actually is natural occurring mineral on our earth, and it's used in many different production lines, in candy and food production, in drugs production, cosmetic production, food, paint, quite many. Also, it's added to cheese and wine to boost the taste. Again, there's nothing wrong with this ingredient, so let's go further on the list. Next ingredient on the list is silica dimethyl silylate. And this is the emollient that basically creates the soft feeling on the lip gloss, that it's, you know, spreading smoothly, that also creates occlusion and protects water to evaporate from the film, from the structure. It's not toxic in small amount, but we are here talking about small amounts, so again, non-toxic product. And then I love what is happening here in this lip gloss, because we are going to explore quite many oils. And I want to put your attention here, because this is exactly what we want to achieve when we look for lip glosses. We want to have natural ingredients, we want to have a lot of good oils, and this is what we will find in those lip glosses, guys. We will have palm oil, we'll have herbacum seed oil. It's basically cotton seed oil. We will have here linseed oil, basically linum oil. Those oils will make our lips more soft, more moisturized, more nourished. They will be very rich in different kind of vitamins. So if you have terrible lips and you need to go and, you know, refresh yourself, I have this lipstick on myself right now, and I had really bad lips when I got up in the morning, and I can just feel that I have beautifully moisturized lips just because of two moves with this lip gloss. Additionally, we will find here Bindus pilosa extract. This is herb extract that basically is described as Botox-like ingredient. It gives anti-aging and extremely nourishing advantages in the product. So guys, we're talking about lip gloss, and I just mentioned so many good ingredients that I'm in love with this product, really. Now, I talked a lot about the lip gloss 3D Hydra, but now we will move to the double touch unlimited with matte finish. They are very popular. I saw them many times on YouTube, and I know that you're a big fan of those. And we have a base color, and then we have a top coat that gives the glossy finish if we want that. So why matte lipsticks are actually matte? Isododecane is not allergic, it's not toxic, non-cancerogenic, you should not be afraid of that. This is the ingredient that makes this super matte finish, that makes sure that our lip gloss lipstick is on our lips, not on the glass or on someone's cheek when we go for a wedding or a party. And also it's great emollient, so protects water from evaporation of the surface. So we don't have to be afraid of that. All the matte lipsticks will not have so many moisturizing ingredients. Definitely will not find their oils, because they will just, you know, those ingredients will just collide with each other and will not get this super matte effect. We can definitely have those put in the top coats that make you this glossy finish. So yes, here we can find some oils, but when you are going for a matte lipstick, this is something that you have to bear in mind, that it will make your lips looking more dry if you use it day after day. Then you will have to moisturize it at night with some additional cosmetics. Apart from that, you will find a lot of silicones here, some polymers of Dimethicone, that it's also totally fine. Dimethicone is one of the best silicone used in cosmetic brands, so nothing to be worried about. Yeah, I felt like I talked a lot about lipsticks, and now I want to review a bit of mascara. As I said, this is a set, and it comes with a primer. Then we have double finish. We can have either a maximum length or maximum volume or both, and you can have a hybrid on your lashes. I have it actually right now on my lashes. The primer here used, if you will look into the ingredients, I again am shocked about how much goodies we will find there. The second ingredient on the list, apart from water, is actually a wax. And wax, as you know, is very healthy, very moisturizing and nourishing for our skin, and in this case lashes. It will create this occlusion, this protecting film over our lashes, and you know, secure it from the external damage, and also from maybe less healthy ingredients from the mascara, and also it will protect it from dryness. So super super good primer. If you are interested, we have here a bee wax, and also we have here, we have also rice wax. And then if we'll go to mascara, I thought, you know, this is like the end. Okay, awesome primer, but then mascara will look totally different. But no, hey guys, it's a series, so it's a set. They have to have similar ingredients. And again, here we will find a lot of good ingredients. Bee wax is a second position. It's a water-based mascara, so water is first, bee wax is second, and then we have nothing wrong, nothing toxic. We also have some bergamot fruit extract, citrus extracts. We have a lot of good stuff here, guys, and I'm so proud of Milano, Kiko Milano. I went to their website, I did massive research about their company, about their values, about satisfaction of their employees who work there. I looked into the series that they are now launching. It's called New Green Me, and they have air shades and colors, very nude, very neutral. They have 90% of the ingredients in this series that is called New Green Me. They have 90% of natural ingredients in all of the products. You will go through the creams or blush or the shadow eyeshadows, it doesn't matter. It's 90% minimum of natural ingredients there. You will find there a lot of cottonseed, avocado oil, you will find argan oil, hyaluronic acid. Those are really stuffed with good things. I also want to mention that this video is not sponsored at all. It's just my, you know, geeky discovering and willing to share with you what is good on the market and what is not. So today we are talking about good stuff, and Kiko Milano is the good stuff. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you would like to get more of those videos, and if you have any specific need or any specific question, put it into the comment. If you liked also the video, give me a thumb up, and see you in next episode. Bye.